Alright, so welcome to a very dull day, potentially a slightly dull video. Was that a good segue? I feel like that was a good segue. Because this is just going to be me talking. There's no drifting in this video, there's no hacking up bits of cars and welding stuff. It's just me chatting about things to come this year, basically. So if that doesn't appeal to you, and I understand why it wouldn't, then feel free to switch off now. I don't want to waste anybody's time. But if you want to hear the kind of plans for this year, especially in terms of competition, like me and Luke competing in drift championships, is that the right phrase? Yeah, we'll call it that. Then, yeah, stick around. All right, so this doesn't get too sort of waffly and boring, I'm going to split this video up into a few different sections. So firstly, why am I going to start competing? Like, why not just carry on drifting how I do now? You know, just going to the occasional practice day, doing whatever. So yeah, the reasons why I want to start getting into competitions. Secondly, what exactly is it that we're going to be getting into? Like, what is the championship, the league, whatever you want to call it, the series? What are we going to be getting into? A bit about that, and like how it feeds into other championships and stuff. And then thirdly, what have I got to do to the car? I should probably start by saying it's the 350 that I'm going to be competing in, not the 86. So what have we got to do to the 350 to get it ready for competitions? And then lastly, my kind of expectations and like goals, I guess, going into competitions. Like, how do I think it's actually going to go, like realistically, and what are kind of like my long-term goals for it. So let's get into that. Right, so first of all then, why compete? Why not just carry on drifting as we have been, just doing practice days, having fun, just messing around? Obviously I'm still going to try and do that as well. Like, this isn't like one or the other. I'm not going to be like, oh, I'm only drifting when it's a competition now. Like, I'm not drifting just for fun. That's not going to be the case at all. So yeah, still going to do just as many practice days, really. Yeah, so the reasons for starting trying competitions. Firstly, I guess I feel like it's just a natural progression. Like, if you're starting to get a bit better at drifting, and don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that I am good at drifting, and we'll get onto that in the expectations bit, I guess. But yeah, like, as you start to get better, I feel like it's a natural next step to try competing. And just, I don't know, add like a competitive element to it. And that is another reason, is that like, when you just go and drift on your own, it's fun. But adding like a competitive element to something can make it more fun. You know, if you go go-karting on your own, it's all right. But if you do it with like 10 other people and you're all competing like for lap times and track position and stuff, it's a lot more fun because you've made it competitive. So like, drifting could be the same. It could be like, oh, it's a load more fun now because there's this whole competitive side to it. Yeah, it'll be fun to see if that side of it is entertaining and fun for me. And also to bring you guys along as well. That is another reason, actually. It's not a reason why I'm doing competitions, but it's a nice bonus, is that I feel like it would be good to have like a video series of someone literally starting at the bottom of competition and kind of hopefully, you know, getting somewhere, like hopefully getting into like the higher championships and stuff eventually. So yeah, it'd be cool for like you guys to see exactly what happens in a competition in the UK, and how it goes, what the format is, and like just follow my kind of journey along, I guess. Like, I feel like in my head that would be a cool sort of thing to watch. Whether it actually will be, I don't know, because, you know, I might get knocked out in the first round every time, like the first qualifying session at every round, and then it'll be pretty dull. But yeah, hopefully if I can actually get into a few battles and stuff, it'll be some good content for you guys. And then the last reason for why I want to drift, it's probably not the last reason, but one of the main ones, is it's a bit deeper, this one, I guess. It's basically that I always feel like I'm pretty shit at things, right? I always feel like I don't really have a clue what I'm doing compared to other people, and especially with drifting, that's the same. Like, I feel like I'm just winging it, and everyone else knows what they're doing, and everyone else is better. And I feel like a lot of people who probably watch the videos think the same. Like, there's probably a lot of people who, you know, everyone criticizes me for using the handbrake too much, all that sort of thing. You know, there's probably a lot of people who think I'm shit, right? So to go into competition, and if I actually manage to do well at some point, I'm not saying I expect to straight away or anything, but if I manage to get better and do well, I feel like that's like a good like confirmation for me, if you know what I mean, like to prove to myself that I'm not shit, you know what I mean, like that I'm actually okay at this, and that, like, you know, and to prove to other people as well. Like, as much as you shouldn't care what other people think, I think it's inevitable for a lot of people, including me, that you do. And you want to not look like you're shit or something. You want to look like you're good at something. So, yeah, like I said, it's kind of a deeper reason, that one. That's more a little look into my psyche for you there, I guess. Like, just yeah, I want to... Like, if somebody's winning or getting on the podium or whatever at drift competitions, no one can be like, oh, yeah, that guy's rubbish. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's like, hey, you've got to be fairly competent to get to that point. You've got to be fairly good all round to be doing well in competitions. And so yeah, that's another reason. But yeah, that's kind of it for why we're gonna try this competition lark. Let's say me and Luke, I don't feel like we're really ready for it yet, either of us. I may as well just cover that now briefly. I originally wasn't gonna try and compete this year. I kept sort of to and fro, and I was like, we're not good enough, we don't get close enough, consistently enough. And that's in like the best case scenario, where we're both in the same car and we're both trying to let it like be easy for each other to follow. So if we're not even doing that well there, then it's going to be really hard in actual competition with different cars or different power levels and stuff. But Luke and a few other people have convinced me that we may as well give it a go. Like, we're not a million miles off, do you know what I mean? It's not like we're like complete beginners at twinning and stuff. But we're certainly not experts at it. So yeah, I'm not sure how well we'll do. But again, we'll get onto that in like the whole expectations section. So I think that'll do for this first section. Let's move on to the actual championship that we're going to try and enter. All right, so the championship, or the series, whatever you want to call it, that we're going to be entering is called Driftcup. Although I should say we're going to try and enter. The tickets are like a first-come, first-served thing. They go on sale in about a month. So I don't know 100% if we're going to be in it or not yet. But we should be. You know, we're both very keen. We're both willing to pay like the full price to do the whole season up front. So hopefully we should get tickets for it. But you never know. And then this whole video will have been a complete waste of time if that's the case. But yeah, hopefully we will get tickets, and then this will have actually been for a reason. I mean, even if we don't, I guess we'll try and get into some other competitions or something. Like, I definitely want to try and compete in some way this year. So we'll do something. But yeah, it's Driftcup, and basically the way Driftcup works is there's, I think, 65 drivers or something at each round, and if you place in the top 8, I'll go through the format first, actually. So the format is, like I say, 60-ish drivers. You all get 2 laps to do a qualifying run, so that's where you're like trying to hit specific clipping points, go as fast as you can, carry as much speed and angle and everything as you can, whilst hitting the clipping points, which is like a little section of the track that you've got to get your back tyres or your front tyres through. And just generally running a good line. You get 2 attempts at that, and you get judged on that. So you get score, you get given a score for each run, and your highest score is like your score. And then that's compared to everyone else, and the top 32 people, like the top 32 scores, go through into the next stage, which is the battles stage. Now in the battles, as you've probably seen if you've ever watched drifting, it's 2 cars, you're matched up against one other person, and you take it in turns. One person leads for the first run, and then you chase. And then you swap round and you lead and they chase. And you get judged based on how well you chased and how well you led. And then obviously there's a lot of stuff that goes into the actual criteria of how they judge it and everything, but I'm not going to get into that now. But that's the basic idea. So then obviously that sort of narrows it down. Everyone's battling everyone else. And it gets narrowed down in brackets until you've just got 2 people left. They battle and that's the final, and that decides who wins. So yeah, it's pretty straightforward. Obviously, like anything that's like a judged sport, it's always a little bit, sometimes you're going to disagree, sometimes you're going to be like, oh, you should have won that, or I should have won that, or whatever. It's not perfect because it is just relying on judges, but it's kind of all you can do with drifting. Like, there's not much else you can do that would just be like a finite answer of whether someone won or not, so it's kind of how it has to work. But yeah, that's what we're getting into, and the way it works is that if you finish in the top 8 at any round, there's 5 rounds of Drift Cup in the year, and if you finish in the top 8 at any of them, you get the option to try out for BDC, which is the British Drift Championship, which is like the next level up. It's the next level up, it's like the highest level in the UK basically. There's SDC, Scottish Drift Championship, and IDC as well, but for now we'll just focus on British Drift Championship. If you finish in the top 8 in Drift Cup at any round, you get the option to try and qualify in BDC at the next round that they do. In the Pro-Am level, there's 2 levels of BDC, Pro-Am and Pro. Pro being the higher one, obviously. And yeah, if you qualify in that, in the next BDC round, then you get put into BDC Pro-Am, and you're out of Drift Cup. Like, you can't be in both. Because Drift Cup is meant to be an entry-level, like, amateur drifting series. So they don't want, like, pros in there that are good enough to be battling with all the really good guys in BDC. So, that's how that works. Yeah, you've got to do as well as you can. And then hopefully, if you do well enough, you get put through to BDC. If not, you can just stay in Drift Cup. Like, even if you do come in the top 8, you can just stay in Drift Cup and try and win that championship. Which, talking to Luke, I think I would probably prefer that, just to get a bit more experience before you go up to play with the big boys, is to just stay in Drift Cup for the first year, even if you did come in the top 8. Because I feel like if you go up to BDC, you suddenly got a whole higher level of competition, higher level of cars. Like the 350 with 270 brake, I think would be a bit outclassed, outpowered in BDC, even Pro Am. So I don't know. That does bring me on to one point though. I might be, well, I say might be. I've pretty much made my mind up that I am at some point going to try and twin turbo 350. Like, and that's kind of based on, yeah, if I get up into a higher level of drift competition, I think, because I'm going to need the extra power then. But I want to do it all myself, the twin turbo, like make everything myself pretty much, not just buy an off-the-shelf kit. But yeah, we'll do a whole separate video on that. That'll be a whole thing. But it's not going to be anytime soon, so yeah, just forget I've said that for now. But yeah, that's it for about the competition, about Driftcup. I feel like I've missed something, but yeah. Let's move on to what we need to do to the car to get it ready. Right, the rules for BDC are quite strict, but the rules for Drift Cup are not that strict in terms of what you have to do to the car. For Drift Cup, you pretty much just need a roll cage of any description, helmet, gloves, a bucket seat, fire extinguisher, and that's pretty much it. Like it's intentionally simple and easy to get into, you know, it's an entry-level competition series. But then the problem is if you move up to BDC, like you can move up at any point, you know, if you come in the top eight in any round of Drift Cup, then you need the car to be up to BDC regulations. So the kind of the general idea that most people do, I think, is to just build the car to BDC regulations, and then you've not got any problems if you do need to move up, or if you get the option to move up. So that's pretty much what we're going to do. I might not get it all done before the first round of Drift Cup, because let's be honest, I'm not going to move up to BDC after one round of Drift Cup, but we're going to make a start on it. It's getting a roll cage next month, so there'll be a full video on that. And we'll go for like full double door bars and everything, like the BDC spec. You've got to have like bonnet catches, you've got to get rid of the original like bonnet pull thing and have like the quick release catches. Same for the boot, you've got to have them. You've got to get rid of aircon, you've got to strip the car out, no carpets and stuff like that. Again, this is all for BDC. What else have we got to do? You've got to have like an electrical cutoff switch. I think you have to have one on the outside as well. And I think you also have to have a plumbed in fire extinguisher system. I can't remember. I need to read up on all the rules again, like I said. But also, like I said, it's not that big of a deal yet, because we're not going to be in BDC anytime soon, I don't think. So yeah, there's quite a lot to be done to the car, but like the roll cage I'm not doing myself, even though I'm tempted, because like I can kind of weld now. It's like, no, let's leave safety stuff to the professionals, all right? Let's not just bodge it together just because I can vaguely weld. We'll do a whole video on the roll cage, painting it and everything as well once it's in. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it for what we're going to do soon. It's like I said, roll cage, the bonnet catches, the boot catches. I might wire in a front-facing brake light, because I'm pretty sure you have to have one of them for BDC. But yeah, there's going to be quite a lot of things, but like I say, we don't have to rush to do any of them just yet. Oh, actually, I've just remembered something that is kind of car-related, is that I need something to tow the 350 with. It's alright going to drift days at the moment and like just hoping I don't break something and still be able to drive home, but in competition it's much more likely that you're going to have a collision or something like that. You're going to be pushing a lot harder, and other people are going to be pushing harder, and you don't know what they're going to do to your car. So I can't just keep driving to events and hoping that I can make it home. So I'm going to have to get a trailer. That's actually where I'm going right now, is to look at a trailer. But the problem is you can't tow with an M4, which is what we're in at the moment. So I'm going to have to get rid of the M4 and get something that I can tow with, which I'll do a separate video on as well. That's a whole separate side of it that's not actually specifically related to the 350, but it's extra stuff I've got to do to prepare for competition. So yeah, that is it for this section. So let's move on to goals, expectations, and like what I hope or think is going to happen. Alright, so I'm a pretty, I like to think, realistic person. I think everyone else would call that negative, but I think I'm just realistic. So I'm not expecting to do well at all in the first, let's say the first year of Drift Cup, really. Like, in my head, I would love, you know, there's still like part of me that's like, oh, well, I'm really good, do you know what I mean? Like, what if I just pull it out of the bag and I just get really like aggressive and really good and like really surprise everyone, including myself. There's always that chance, you know, there's always that chance that the level of competition could be lower than you're expecting. Like, this is the thing, I really don't know how good everyone else is going to be. So I think a lot of it is going to be luck as to who you get put up against if you make it through to the battles, like on the first battle. You could just get knocked out by the fucking best guy every time in your first battle, like if you're really unlucky. But hopefully we'll get a bit of experience with a few battles. I mean, that's if we even make it through qualifying. Like, realistically, I think we should make it through qualifying. Like, I think both me and Luke's got quite a bit less experience than me in terms of how many drift days he's done, but he's good. He's learned a lot faster than I have. And I think, like he goes a bit too aggressive sometimes, but I think if he just controls himself, he'll be fine. So I think for me personally, I'll be fine just hitting clipping points and doing stuff. Like, I might still end up using a bit too much hydro or whatever, just for the consistency and for the reliability, which I don't know if you get, like, deducted points for that or not. I've no idea what their view on hydro usage is. But I think, realistically, for the first round, which is at Rockingham in March, I should be able to qualify. I'm hoping. That's kind of my goal, is if I can qualify, get into the top 32, then I'll be happy. Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't think I can be too pissed off with that. But the main thing is going to be the battles. And I, honestly, like, when me and Luke are practicing, I don't understand how people battle. Like with cars they've never been behind before. Because, like I say, me and Luke are behind each other, like, all the time. And we're in the same car, very similar setups, and we're trying to make it easy to chase. Like, you know, we're on the, like, radio switch, they're saying, oh, can you just go a little bit slower at the start, whatever, so give me a bit more chance to get alongside you, whatever. You don't have that luxury in a competition. Everyone's trying to beat you, not help you. So, if you come up against a guy that you've never been behind before and you're chasing him first, or even, well, whichever way around it is, you've just got to, the first corner is what I'm scared of. It's like, you've just got to commit so much and hope that he does what you think he will do. And he might not. He might enter way slower than you expect, or he might do a completely different type of entry than you expect, or he might just have way more grip and way more power and just clear off and you've got no chance. But, like, how do you know until you get to that first corner? And by that point, it's kind of too late. Like, if one thing I've learned from trying to twin with Luke is that if you mess up the first corner and you're too far back, it really ruins your whole run. Like, you spend the whole run just trying to catch up, because you can't just straighten up and drive straight towards them, because then you lose points for that anyway. So you've got to stay drifting, which means you're not really picking up much speed most of the time. So, like, how do you catch up? You have to cut the track quite a lot, which, again, is frowned upon, you lose points. So, yeah, I don't know, I'm really wary and really, like, keen to see how we get on. Because, yeah, to me, it just seems like madness that you just follow someone in that you've probably never been behind before and just dive into the first corner and try to get on their door. It's going to be fucking crazy. So, yeah, we'll see how that goes. And also, like, when I'm leading, I'm going to be wary, like, what if I'm going a lot slower than people expect and someone just smashes straight into me? Like, yeah, I've got no idea. I think probably the higher up in competition you get, like, when you get into BDC and stuff, it probably gets easier, if anything, because the cars are probably more similarly matched in terms of power and grip, and the driving level is more similarly matched. Like, you can expect what people are going to do a bit more. I remember when I did track days, the worst, like, group to be in, like, on bike track days, this is, was the novice group, because you had no idea where people were going to go, but it'd be on all sorts of weird lines. So when you're trying to go past someone, they sometimes just suddenly pull into the middle of the track, and you're like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, whereas when you got up into the higher groups, everyone's on that racing line, and you know what they're going to do. So I feel like that's probably the same in drifting, but, yeah, we've got to start at the bottom, we've got to start in the entry level, because that's the level that we're at. We are going to be the idiot that does something someone doesn't expect. So, yeah, I don't know, it's going to be good. My long-term goals, I guess, like, I'd like to get up into BDC at some point, but, like I said, I think it would do me good to just, even if I did get in the top 8 somehow in the first year of Drift Cup, it would probably do me good to just get a bit more experience of competition in Drift Cup, rather than just, like, I'd rather do well in Drift Cup than do shit in BDC. Do you know what I mean? Like I'd rather get my skills up there and get more experience and then go into BDC and actually stand a chance of getting somewhere. Like again, not under any impressions that I'll be, like, doing really well. Like, I don't know if I'd ever see myself mixing up with the pros, you know what I mean? Like Martin Richards and, like, Phil Morris and all those guys, like the proper high level, like Jack Shanahan, everyone. All those guys that are proper high level. I don't know if I'd ever be up there. Maybe, you know, in a few years, maybe with more experience, who knows? But yeah, at the moment, that just seems like way out of reach. For now, I'm just focusing on can I do well in Drift Cup and then potentially in BDC Pro-Am? And then, yeah, that's kind of my long-term goal, is to just do well in BDC Pro-Am, I guess, like try and get towards podiums on that. But that is a very long-term goal. I'm not expecting that to happen in the first couple of years. So, yeah, like I said, hopefully it'll be fun for you guys to follow along with the journey, especially if we do start doing well and like progressing up the ranks. It'll be kind of cool for you to see. I'll let you guys know if we don't get tickets somehow for Drift Cup. But if you don't hear anything else, just assume that we'll be competing in the first round in March, which, like I say, is part of the Rockingham Matsuri. So it'll probably be two videos. I'll do one video of the Saturday where we're just practicing, just messing about with the Matsuri, and then a separate video of the competition, which I'm going to be so nervous on the first run, like the first few qualifying laps. Well, you only get two qualifying laps. I'm going to be so nervous, but it'll be good. It'll be a good experience. Hopefully I don't just go out straight away and then there's no content at all for you guys, but yeah, we'll try and do well, try and at least get into one battle, and yeah, see how it goes. I'm not sure what the rules are on like filming and stuff, but I'll have to find out. I'm sure I've seen people with helmet cams and GoPros mounted on the roof and stuff, so I'm sure we'll be able to put something together from each round of Drift Cup, and yeah, hopefully you guys will enjoy following along. So yeah, that's it. This has been a really long video, sorry I've waffled so much, but yeah, I don't know what the next video is going to be, kind of thing, probably the competition prep one. Oh no, actually there's two drift days coming up. There's a drift day at Rockingham coming up in a couple of weeks, and then a drift day at Santa Pod, and then yeah, then it's going for the cage after that. But yeah, I'll see you in some kind of video. There'll be something coming out soon, so I'll see you there.